Hey there, it's Michael here with another Python short to show you something awesome about Python in just a few minutes. In this one, we're going to focus on loops, foreign loops, and those sorts of things. Maybe you've heard the statement, you shouldn't use loops in Python, or you should write a lot fewer loops in Python. What are people talking about? That seems weird. It turns out Python has expressions and language constructs that allow you to write more concise and more reusable types of things that would replace a for in loop. You might even seen articles like this. You probably don't need the for in loop. If you've been wondering what the heck these are all about, that's what we're going to show you in this video. We're over here in PyCharm. Let's dig in. We've got this simple loops to comprehension code that we're going to work with, and we have some data. We're going to load up all of this data here, and it's really trying to model some sort of car, auto dealership, manufacturer. So we've got customer data. Here's their name, here's their email, and the car that they bought. Of course, this is vastly simplified. You wouldn't really model it this way, but it's what we're going to work with. So you'll see that Dell bought a Scion 2006, Donovan bought a BMW M5, and so on. Now, over in our code, we load up this list, and then we loop over it, printing out information about that. Let's go ahead and run it, see what it looks like. Just like you would expect, Dell bought their Scion for this amount, Donovan bought their BMW, and so on. All right, so this is just fake data that I put in here, but it gives us lots of data to work with. You see 10 listed here, but there's actually 1,000 entries in that file. We're going to convert all that data in that file over to a list of auto customers. Now, here's the method we're going to focus on. Load list. Here's a list of auto customers. We're getting that data from the file, and then we're looping over it because it's just dictionaries which come out of here, and we want it as that class above. So what we're going to do is we're going to loop over and create a list, use a for-in loop, go over each entry. Because the entries in the dictionary match the field names in this class, that was on purpose, we can just use star star entry to copy that over, to load it up, and then we put it in our list and we return it. And that's what we get right here. Fantastic. So what's wrong with this code? People told you you shouldn't do this. Well, there's nothing really wrong with it, but there are other ways to do it that you may choose. We can use what's called a list comprehension. So let's comment this out so you still have it hanging around. And instead of writing all of this, we can write what's called a list comprehension. Typically, when we create a list, we write something like this, like line 45. We were doing that before, but there's another thing you can do where you write expressions in here. So you could say, let's call it final item for some sort of item in, let's call it data set. We could do if test. So this is the format of a list comprehension. You have something you want to be in the list, and you say for, right, kind of this bit right there, for some piece of data, which may or may not be the final item in the data set. And you can also limit what goes in there. We're not going to do that in this case because we just want to put them all in. What's the data set? It's what we got back up here. It's raw data. The item is what we're using in our list entry. And we don't want to return the dictionary. We want a list of auto customers. And so that's what we were doing. We were creating this little C and we were putting it in the list. We can just do this right where that final item bit goes. And let's run it and see if we get the same output. We do, because they mean the same thing. And sometimes this is actually computationally faster in Python than this arbitrary loop because it knows exactly what you're trying to do. You're trying to build up a list out of this data and so on. We could even inline this. We could come over here and say inline like that. And now our function basically becomes two lines of code. Get the data from the file, convert it to list, we're done. And again, still works exactly the same. So this is called a list comprehension. It's pretty awesome. What do you think? Are list comprehensions awesome? Do you find good uses of them in your code? Well, let us know down in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, do please press the like button. It super helps support our work. That's it. You now know how to convert from a for-in loop over to a list comprehension and back if you need to. Hopefully you found this to be educational and informative. If you did, consider clicking on my face up there and subscribing to the channel. Also, over on Talk Python to Me, the podcast, we talk about this kind of stuff all the time. And at Talk Python Training, we have hundreds of hours of Python courses diving deep into these things. So if you want to go deeper, check those two resources out as well. Thanks for watching. Catch you next time.